Hey, welcome to the sixth and final lesson of our Dialogflow series. In our previous lessons, we've been building our different intents and flows using Dialogflow and Landbot. We've created this flow that loops so that all that is said in the bot is sent to Dialogflow, processed there, and sent back to Landbot to be displayed. But the best usage of Dialogflow with Landbot is when you use the best of both tools at once. One, to understand and capture users' inputs, which is done by Dialogflow, and what we've been doing in all the previous lessons. And the other one, to use and make different operations with information gathering, which is done by Landbot. So in this lesson, we'll see how to redirect users to specific flows based on intent name and entities. So let's start with how to redirect users using the intent name in Dialogflow. For example, in this agent, we set flows based on four intents, this being FAQ delivery, FAQ hours, FAQ location, and reservation trigger. Now, if we head back to Landbot and click on the Dialogflow block, first of all, you'll need to check the Show Advanced Configuration box. You will see now that new options are displayed. Scroll down and open the Save the Response category. In the section Intent Name, we will create a Landbot variable to store the intent that will be triggered by Dialogflow. Now, as we want to set up different flows based on the agent's intents, we will use a keyword jump block, which is used to redirect the flow based on keywords. So the variable to match will be the recently created variable. And as keywords, we will set the different intent names we currently have listed in Dialogflow. Be aware that the keywords will only trigger if written exactly as it is in your Dialogflow account. The words are case sensitive, so keep that in mind. Great, let's now connect each flow to the respective message we want the users to receive. For this example, I will just write the flow triggered so we can better understand what is happening. But ideally, each flow would have its respective blocks and messages. We will connect the default path to the previous question block, creating a loop that will always manage to send information back to the user, even if no intent is triggered. Great, so save, and let's preview the bot. So let's say the user types something like, "Where are you located?" The bot then will take the location flow. Great. Another really useful intent that you can have if you have agents in Landbot is to set up a human takeover intent in Dialogflow. So in case the user types something like, "I want to speak with a person," or "I need help from a real human," you can redirect them to a flow where there is a human takeover block. Cool, let's now see how to redirect users to specific flows based on entities. We know from previous lessons that entities are another type of parameters that we can extract from Dialogflow, and that they are shown inside your Dialogflow account. So let's add them to our block inside Landbot. For the first intent, we set the entity date time associated with add reservation date. And we also have the number of people of the reservation with the add people variable. Great, but we know that these entities will only be captured by the reservation trigger flow. So let's add a conditional block specifically for this flow. For this example, we will say that if add people is greater than 6, the flow will follow the green path and send them this GIF. But if they are less than 6, it will follow the red path and we will send them this other one. Cool, save, go to share and preview. Let's try to book a table for 10. And as you can see, we're directly redirected to the green path. Awesome, I must say that apart from intent name and entities, there are other advanced parameters that can be used to redirect the users to different flows. These advanced parameters are these three over here called output context, payloads, and query responses. We won't get into them in this course because the videos would be like 10 times longer, but there is some great documentation out there that explains how they work. Well, that was all. This is the end of our Dialogflow course. I really hope each video was clear and understandable, and that it helped you integrate Dialogflow with Landbot. I recommend you checking our documentation as it is updated more often than these videos. I'm Nick, and I'll see you around the Academy.